In this module, we are going to talk about the role of industrialization. In the early days of the Industrial Revolution, nobody had an inkling that burning of fossil fuels would contribute to global warming and climate change. The greater greenhouse effect is the result of additional heat reserved to the increased amounts of carbon dioxide and other greenhouse gases. Human industrial activity released these excessive gases into the Earth's atmosphere. But question is, now we know that this industrialization process is really making a heavy toll upon the environment. Are we ready to protect our environment after knowing this? This is a million-dollar question. The richest and most developed countries in the world are responsible for the catastrophe of global climate change. These developed nations are the largest emitters of greenhouse gases. The top-ranked contributors are the United States and the countries of Europe, which grow their economies by burning fossil fuels and emitting large amount of carbon from their factories, homes, and cars. In our previous modules, we shared many times with you that it is America which is emitting 24% carbon dioxide of the world in the air. That is number one country in emitting 24% world carbon dioxide in the air. And then it is also explained that how Europe is also contributing in damaging the environment. Here is the slide that is showing that how it is happening, contribution of different sectors in world to climate change. See, wastewater 2.8%, forestry 17.4%, agriculture 13.5%, industry 19.4%, energy supply 25.9%, transport 13.1%, and residential and commercial buildings, they are contributing 7.9%. So energy supply, if you could see, that is 25.9%, almost 26% it is sharing regarding damaging the environment. Although the developed countries are responsible for climate change, but the poor countries will face the gravest consequences. Poor countries are at greater risk and have the most difficulty to cope with the problem. So we cannot alienate ourselves that thinking it is coming from the West or the developed part of the world and we are not doing anything and we will live in peace and in a clean environment, it is not possible. We are part of this global community. So if any damage is happening at a global level, that would ultimately damage us all. Here are the examples of poor countries that how this role of industrialization is damaging the poor countries. Low-lying Bangladesh that has already been sufferer of powerful cyclones could lose 10% of its territory to the ocean within a few decades owing to this climate change happenings. It would contribute to displacing approximately 18 million people. So Bangladesh is under threat owing to this climate change and industrialization process, how it is changing our climate. Sub-Saharan Africa, another example, and Central Asian are more prone to the climate change as compared to the United States and European nations. These poor nations are already suffering from numerous issues. Political instability, violence, droughts, poor harvests, homelessness. Now question is, if United States and China are number one and two countries in emitting the largest number of carbon dioxide in the air, why they themselves are not being damaged environmentally? Because both countries are also doing some, are taking some measures to correct the environment, to replete the ozone layer, or to repair the ozone layer, which is depleting very fastly. For example, in America, there are already electronic cars or automobiles are being driven. In China, it is also happening in the same way. But in the developing part of the world, facing the brunt. Why? Because whatever the climate change is happening, the developing world has not as much resources to rescue itself from the damages of the climate change. That is why we are saying that it is more detrimental for the developing world.